It's just me today. Hey, I'm Brenda Baker of Mom's Mixed Family Blender, and today I want to talk to you about step-parent struggles and understanding how to forgive and what you don't see, okay? So there may be a contingency of you that have stepchildren or are stepchildren, and you've struggled with your step-parent or your stepchild. And so I want to shed some light onto some of the issues that we have seen over and over and over again when it comes to stepchildren. Now, some of these things I've experienced myself, and then other things, you know, we have been helping people with their blended families for over 20 years. And it's really interesting how, you know, when there are problems, what step-parent challenges will come up with the kid. And how often step-parents are blamed for things that they may or may not have been able to control at the time. And so we're going to talk about all of those things. And I'm going to give you three tips, maybe four, but definitely three tips on how to deal with your step-parent in a better healing sort of way. Now, the first thing I want to say is your feelings are not anyone else's responsibility but yours. So stepchild, please understand that how you feel about a certain situation, that's not your step-parent's problem, okay? That is on you. You are an adult, or maybe you're in your later teens. Either way, it's your responsibility. And so if you are in your younger teens and you're starting to become adult, it's time to learn how to take responsibility for your own feelings. And that doesn't mean that you get to project what your problems are and they become gospel onto your step-parent. Now, here is the universal, in my opinion, the universal unpopular opinion about step-parents and in-laws. You, as the stepchild or the daughter or son-in-law, you have a heck of a lot more understanding and grace for either your parent or your biological, you know, your parent, actually, in both situations. You have more grace and more understanding most of the time, not everyone, but most people, than you do for your step parent or your in-laws. And so that's on you. You're the only common denominator there. Okay? You choose not to give grace. And I'm sorry, but any loving step-parent, which is someone who has not been physically or sexually abusive, someone who actually wants to have a relationship with you and has tried, whether you think so or not, any step-parent that loves you wants to see you do well. They have done what they've done based on the information that they knew, whether or not you agree with that, they have done the best they can. But for some reason, people will tend to forgive their biological parents for any stupid, crazy thing that their parents have done, but they won't with their in-laws or with their step-parents. So my encouragement there is check yourself. Write a list of all the things that you're so angry about, okay? What is it? And then I want you to look at that list and I want you to boil down what your actual issue is with your step-parent or your in-law, okay? Now, I didn't plan on making this video about in-laws, but I have seen this over and over and over again. The same issues. They're very, very similar. Then I want you to ask yourself, if my biological parent did this, would I be okay with it? Now, I personally, at one point, our oldest son, who is my stepson, one of them, he looked at me and he was probably 14, maybe 15. And he looked at me and he said, why is it that you can love me, but my mom can't? But yet now he tells people I was abusive, I was terrible, and I am the problem. Interesting. Okay. Now, I don't know where he was at in his mind when he said that. I don't know why he said that. His mom did make a lot of choices that did seem, even to me, like she didn't really care about the oldest specifically. The other one, not so much. She made very different decisions with the other one. Because one of them reminded her of my husband and the other one didn't. So yeah. So I want you to write this list down. Write all your problems down. Figure out what it is that you are so upset with your step-parent about. And I want you to decide that you are going to go to your step-parent and you're going to stop talking about them and you're going to talk to them, okay? Now, when you go to talk with them or to them, I want you to have the mind of, this is going to help our relationship. We're going to start afresh. We're going to get these things out in the open and we're going to deal with it. Okay. Part of relationships, every relationship is dealing with things. And if things have just been hidden for years and years and years, and you've just had all these feelings, but you've never been the one that has said, hey, this really upset me and this is why. You've never given your parent or whatever relationship you're even talking about, you've never given them the opportunity to say, hey, I had no idea that bothered you. Here's what I was trying to do. Now, some of these things have happened over your lifetime, right? Some of these things, they may not even remember why, or maybe they have an apology to make. You know, I've made many, many apologies to all of our kids, to be honest. Well, not our second oldest, because he left the family and hasn't looked back. You know, when he was 14, he left the family and nothing else has been said except for abuse and blah, blah, blah. You know, he's just run his mouth. You know, we don't know if tomorrow is guaranteed because it's not. So you don't know if what you're doing and what you're thinking right now is actually the case. So I encourage you to go and talk to your step parent. Have your bio parent there if you want to, just not the one that isn't married to him. Because frankly, family issues are family issues. And I got news for you. Maybe you don't know this, but family equals problems. There are problems in families, every single family. There is no perfect family. Even if you think that your best friend or your cousin or something has a perfect family, years down the road, a lot of the times you find out what actually happened. They just didn't talk about it, okay? There's problems. And so relationships, if they're important to you, which surely your bio parent that's married to your step parent is important to you, right? If that's the case, then you're going to do what you need to do to fix the relationship. Because I can guarantee you, I've seen this over and over and over again, and it's the story in our life. Stepkid gets mad. Stepkid or step-parent finally is like, whatever, I'm done with you, kid. Figure it out and let me know when you're ready. And then nothing. Period. Nothing happens. Because stepkid doesn't want to believe that they did anything wrong. So now they just shell out the anger and discourse, and it affects the relationship with the entire family, whether they want to believe that or not. Okay. The grandparents are affected. Their personal kids, if they have kids, are affected. Their spouse is affected. Their bio parents are affected. The step parent, like, and any siblings along with their family, every single person in the family is affected in some way. Is that what you want? Regardless of what you think, it took your step-parent a lot to raise you, because it's hard to raise somebody else's kids because, and this is the biggest reason, it's hard because they don't have your genes. So there aren't things that you're going to understand that they're doing. It's not because you don't like them. It's just, it's like, where is that coming from? Like, why are you doing that? Because typically speaking, when you have a bio child, it is a little easier because they either act like you or they act like your spouse, or, you know, or a combination of them. So you can figure it out. That's why it's so important to stay with your original spouse. Okay. But there's something flying. But yet at the same time, like, divorces are going to happen, right? So it is on my heart to just say, do the hard things. If you're a step parent and you're watching this, or a bio parent, and you're trying to understand these things, Mel Robbins has a really good thing that she talks about, and it's the let them policy. Okay. Whatever your stepkid thinks, let them. They're not going to think what you want to think, because they don't know what you know. They don't know what you know about their other bio parent that you're not married to. They don't know how much you sacrificed for them. They don't know what it took to pay your child support and still try to live with any other kids that you have, right? They don't know these things. They don't know how hard it was. They might have been there, but they really didn't know, okay? And as a caveat, you don't know what the other bio parent outside the house was saying. Because parental alienation is really something, and it's hard. My husband was alienated from his second oldest son, our second oldest son, from the time he was little tiny. Because his ex-wife had many affairs, but one supposedly resulted in the second oldest child. And so he was told from the time he was little tiny that my husband was not his dad. Now that's abuse. That is parental abuse. It is verbal abuse. It is parental alienation. And there are lots of other terms I could use here. And so if you're going to come to the comments and you're going to get all grumpy with me, go ahead. I don't care. I could care less what you think. The whole point is that a child's perception of their step-parent, even of their bio-parent that the step-parent is married to, is askew because of things that are said. Whether it be teachers, principals, church, people that they know, whatever. And we, Mike and I, had a gambit of BS that happened within our church at the time. We no longer attend, thank God. We had a lot of haters because we were trying to step out and we were giving our opinion on blended families and people didn't like it. So I went way off. See, this is why I do these videos with Mike, is because he keeps everything in line and on track. So I apologize. Tip number two is your step parent has given a lot of effort, if you think so or not. Here, I'm going back. Number three, how many of your feelings or thoughts of your bio parent and step parent were given to you by the other bio parent? I think what I was actually trying to do before is I was trying to segue into number three, but hey, Mike does it way better than I do. But yeah, be honest with yourself. Do you even know? Can you even think back and remember some of the hurtful comments that your bio parent that doesn't live in the house said about your step parent and your bio parent in the house? Do you even know? Okay, you were a child, so is it possible that some of your ideas, excuse me, are from someone else and were put there on purpose? Just curious. So really, you know, blended families require a lot more forgiveness. Blended family forgiveness needs to be a whole video of its own, because we see over and over and over and over issues that come up. Now, not to say that they don't come up in regular married couples, families, right? But it seems to be more rampant and more feelings are connected to issues that happen in blended families. Now, I'll be honest, I got sick and tired of our oldest flapping his gums to everyone but me about me, okay? I got sick and tired of constantly feeling like I had to manage the drama that he would chart, that he would start. It got to the point where I just didn't even want to be around him anymore. I mean, he was just so, so difficult. And it would be in small ways. But unfortunately, some of those small ways were very similar to things that his mother did. And that got to be so overwhelming that I just couldn't have that negativity anymore. And then you add in some of his own personal family with his wife and his stepchild. And it was just too much. I mean, kind of a last straw thing happened. And I just got to the point where it was time. It was time to put my boundaries. Prior to that, I had very few boundaries when it came to things. And so what I would tend to do is I would hold, not say anything, try to keep the peace. And then I would blow up at people because I had no boundaries. So that was on me. But I think that blended family forgiveness and, you know, stepkids understanding where the step parent is coming from, it's tricky. It's going to take time. It's going to take patience, understanding, love. Are you willing? Are you willing to do the work? Because your step parent is not going to do it. It's not their responsibility. They tried. Okay. And I don't care what you think. Your step parent tried. If they were not abusive and they did not sexually abuse you, like, shut up. Don't even talk to me about how your step parent, from your opinion, was abusive. That's ridiculous. Stop it. You just don't want to talk about things. Now, yes, step parents make decisions that are the wrong decisions sometimes. Absolutely. I have. Oh yeah. There's many things that I would definitely take back, but you can't. Once things are said and done, like, what are you going to do about them then? But your bio parent, their life is not guaranteed. They might die today in a car accident. Do you want to live with the regret of never making things right? It's up to you. You can stay angry. I have a family member who has been angry with their stepmother their entire life, pretty much. And I got to tell you, it's hard to raise somebody else's kid. Especially under the circumstances that this person was raised. And I'm not going to say any more than that, but if you are in a situation where you're older and you're still holding things against other people, that is your fault. Regardless of what happened to you, it is your responsibility to let it go, because it will eat you up. It will affect your health. It will affect all your relationships prior to that or after that. I mean, it's going to continue affecting you until you choose different. And you might say to yourself, well, I have a good marriage. Okay. We'll see how that keeps going. Because what I can tell you from the 20 years experience that I have working with other couples, it does not stick to just your step parent. It goes out from there. So if you are a step kid and you're married, understand that you are going to have some marriage problems. They're going to come up. And you're going to default to what you've already done. Do you want that? I hope you don't. I hope you want to solve the problems. So do that list, write it down, boil it down to what your actual problems are. Think about whether or not those problems are actually problems or if they just hurt your feelings. Because feelings don't matter at this point. Family matters a lot. So with that, I hope this wasn't too, you know, like all over the map. I hope that it gave you some tips, but also gave you some tough love, because that was my plan, is to give you what you needed to hear rather than what you want to hear. You're not going to be okay with God until you make it right. And if you're my stepchild and you're watching this, dude, I'm not talking to you. If it applies to you, great. If you don't think it does and you everything's my fault, that's fine too. I don't want it that way, but that's the choice. But anywho, yeah, I hope this just kind of gives you some tips and helps you to understand the decisions that you're making. And I hope that you choose to have that blended family forgiveness and start the ball rolling so that you can build a new relationship and get back into your family. Because chances are, if you've had problems with your step-parent and you've chosen to not have anything to do with them, or they have with you, it's not going to be better anytime soon. Nothing's going to happen. They're not going to just appear at your doorstep just because they owe it to you. Sorry, that's not how it works. You need to be the bigger person, and not that step-parents that aren't saying something aren't the bigger person. Sometimes people have to wallow in what they choose. So I hope this gave you some tips. I hope that you feel that it was worth your time to watch, and I will talk to you again soon. Bye.